What's up everyone, Fazro here. So when I started using Figma back to the 2018, I have no idea about Figma because I wanted to switch from the sketch. And from that moment to now, I have done countless projects in Figma, and what I have learned that you can save your tons of time with the tips which I'm going to share with you in this video. So in this video, I'm going to share with you my top 10 essential tips for Figma to make your workflow super fast. So first tip, I'm going to share with you color style generate within a 2 seconds. So in Figma, creating a style guide is so much time consuming when you have to define all the colors one by one, and it is so much time consuming. What if you can create this style guide within a 2 seconds by follow two-step process? So here it is. So first of all, just select all the layers where you have color. In my example, I have this pink color. So now I'm going to rename this multiple layers. You can rename multiple layer by selecting and press command R. So you can see this rename pop up in Figma. And now I can rename, like example color. Inside the colors, I have pink. And I also can generate auto number over here. So if I click, you can see auto generated number 1, 2, 3, 4, ascending, descending, whatever your choice. And even I can modify. So you can see 100, 200, 300 shades in Figma. It's pretty easy. If I click on this, you can see this layers. And now we are going to follow the second step to define the colors into your style guide. So for this, we need a plugin called Color Chroma Color. You can download this plugin from the Figma community, it's free. And if you click on this plugin, that's it. You just generated your color style very, very quickly. So the same process you can follow again and again, and you can save your tons of time. So let me know if you know about this tip or not. So now moving into the second one called swiping components super fast. So, okay. So in Figma, you have a few ways to add or, you know, replace the component, like click on the assets and you can just simply add your component, whatever component you have defined in Figma example over here. And you can also click over here and you can click over here and you can swipe the enhance, whatever component you selected, you can replace with another component, pretty easy way, right? But what if you have 100 of the component and you want to save your tons of time, and maybe you have a very big design system? What you can do here is a trick. You can change super fast your component. In my example, I want to change this component. So I'm tracking over here on my artboard, and just follow two step called command and option key in your Mac keyboard. While you pressing, you will see the blue border over here. You see, that's mean you can replace this component with the component you are holding. So if I leave my mouse, that's it. So this is how you can save your time, and it's super fast and super easy. Let's try over here. Let's change this icon. I want to add this edit icon over here. While I'm holding this icon, just press command and option key and you will see the blue boundary or blue border anywhere you want to replace, and just leave your mouse. That's it. It is so much easy, right? And this is how, like, you just more focus on your design. So now we are moving into the next one called copy paste style. And I know some of the people are watching me, they know copy paste style, but I'm gonna share with you more deeper how you can copy specific style and paste. So first of all, let's talk about the basic copy paste style. So in Figma, Figma allows you to copy all the properties, whatever you applied, from the right panel called property panel, colors, stroke, effects. You can simply copy this all style by following the shortcut called command option C, and you can simply apply wherever you want to apply. In my case, I want to apply over here. So for applying, I have to follow like command option V. Simple and that. This is how it's work. But the problem is with this style, copy paste style, that it's copying all the property from the property panel. But some of the time I want to copy only shadow or like only border, and how I can do. So here is a trick. So for this, let's say in my case, I want to copy only shadow and I want to apply over here. So for this, just select your layer. Where is your shadow or effect? Just simply come over here in the corner and click. Now you can see it's selected. And you also can do multiple select. For copying this style, we are following the command C. And now if I have to apply this style over here, for applying, I have to select my layer. And after this, I have to follow the shortcut command option V. That's it. This is super simple. And this is how you can do. And In Figma, the beautiful thing about Figma, Figma allow you to apply the style onto groups, layers, and the frames. So now let's talk about the resizing artboard and the scale component. If you're coming from the Sketch or Adobe XD, there is artboard, but in Figma, there's no artboard. We call the frame, and you might have a problem in Figma if you are new. If you're resizing your artboard, your component also being resized. And this is kind of like an issue because Figma don't differentiate between the artboard and the component you're making, because it's also artboard. If I deattach, you can see, which is we call frames, sorry. So to avoid this problem, if you have to resize this artboard, which is frame again, you can do by simply follow the one command called command. If you're pressing the command key and resizing, it's not gonna hurt any property inside the artboard. So this is how you can save your, sometimes this is how you can avoid this problem. And even you, if you want to do both sides, you can follow command option key and you can just resize both sides, even like this. But what if you have to scale the component or scale the design in Figma? There is only one way to do it. If you see this move icon over here, if you click on this drop down, just select the scale. You can also follow the command key for the scale. Over here, if I go, you can see this icon, scale icon, have a two arrows up and down, and now I can simply scale this component. But I will not recommend you to scale because of it will change every single thing, typography, design, image size, and every single thing. I think this is very useful for those things where you have to post your Instagram post or maybe dribble post. In this condition, you can just simply scale instead of exporting PNG or JPEG, whatever it's called. So this is how it's work. So now let's move into the next one, which is I'm pretty excited. This feature is really time saving for me every single time. So here I'm gonna share with you how you can work smart with the smart selection. It's called tidy up. I hope I'm pronouncing right. So the thing is, if you want to align this all the design in a structure like a grid view, you have to follow the two step. Either you just, you know, select one by one like this and align, or either you go one by one, whatever you call. But what if you just click only one magic click and everything is aligned according to you? So this is how you can do. So first of all, you have to go in your main group over here, and inside the main group, you have all the tiles, okay? So after selecting, if you hover your cursor on the selection, you will see this small icon, it's called tidy up. So if I click on this icon, you will see it's automatically aligned for you. And now you can do few things inside. You can resize this padding up and down, whatever you prefer. Even you can customize your padding from over here, like 16:16. Even sometimes if this option is not visible, you can go over here, this icon, and click on tidy up. And now it's again, it's working. So just keep in mind, sometimes this icon is not coming in Figma. I don't know why, but it's really, I don't know. And also what you can do, you can also, you know, like change the position. It's really, really helpful. So now let's move into the next one called renaming. If you are very like organized guy like me, I always managing my design by giving the right names to them, by, you know, organizing so much, because I want to understand what layer and what section I'm working. But it doesn't mean that I'm spending a lot of time on organizing my design. So, but what I do mostly, I do renaming very quickly, very, very quickly. So I'm gonna share with you three steps for renaming. First of all, if you want to rename this layer, you have two ways. Either you double click, or either you can simply press command R for the rename like this. So let's say I'm gonna do avatar. And if there is all the objects over there, like groups over here, you can do very quicker renames by following the same shortcut which I talk about, command R after selecting multiple layers, and let's say avatars. That's it. Even if you want to rename this layers very quickly, what you can do, you can use tabbing system and command R. Tabbing, tap, 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 tap. Now you can do very, very fast. So it is a really good practice for me because I just want to see well organized, very well organized my design. So now let's move into the next one called nudge. What is nudge, first of all? So nudge is kind of like, you can say, the spacing every single time you're taking one step, two step, by using arrow key up and down, left, right, whatever. But what if you want to define the principle that every single time if I press my shift with the arrow, it's move only 8 pixel, or maybe it's move only 4 pixel, you can do by setting up the nudge. So for this, you have to go into the Figma icon over here, go preference and go nudge amount, and you can say, let's say I'm working on the 8 pixel grid, and now if I'm moving by pressing shift key on the top, you see 16 8 4, and this is really, really helpful to managing all the spacing. Like if you have defined the principle, like hold the design is going to follow 8 pixel principle. So follow this tip to make your design pixel perfect design. So now let's move to the next one. We are almost there, as I believe. And now I'm going to talk about very big thing called auto layout. Let me take a breath. So if you don't know about auto layout is really powerful in Figma. And this is the most beautiful feature of the Figma. So let me give you 3 examples how this auto layout is work. So let's say I have this dialog box from the material design. So let's say if I delete any item from over here, it's automatically resizing the whole component. And it's very useful time saving because I don't need to do manually like this, you know, resize. The same example from the iOS, if I select and delete, you see, and even you can see this tab bar from the material design. If I delete any item from over here, it's going to immediately distribute the space in one line. So this is how this auto layout is work. It's so much powerful. So I'm going to give you a very basic example. For this, we are going to build this whole thing into the auto layout. For creating this auto layout, you simply select the all design elements, and you can see this auto layout over here. If you will not see this thing, just press shift A to convert into the auto layout. Now you can differentiate this icon between this icon. This is auto layout icon. And now in going inside, and you can see I have row converting into the auto layout, again converting into the auto layout, this whole thing. And after this, I'm building one more auto layout. So as you can see, I have one more, like this is a main, and after this I have child. And now I'm going to use some of the basic functionality of the auto layout. Let's say click on this fill width. Now you can see it's fill, and the same thing for this again, and changing some of the functionality over here, space between. Sorry for that, but this video is not about completely auto layout, but I'm going to share with you some of the greatest thing about auto layout. So now we have this, and I'm giving some of the padding 24 pixel, let's say. So as you can see over here, and now I'm deleting this spacing. Let me add the fill color. Now I'm adding a border radius. So one more thing, if you see your image is not covering the frame because you have to click on this clip content. This whole design is based on the auto layout, but what are the benefits? If I delete anything from over here, you see it's automatically resized. Even you can fix the height. So example, if I fix the height over here, and if I come on my image, I say fill container, and if I delete anything, it's automatically filling. So this is the power of auto layout. So let me know if you want to see a video where I can give you a deep understanding about auto layout. So now let's move into the last tip, which is called auto layout hover. So there is a very big problem with the auto layout that sometimes when you have auto layout, as you can see, I have this messages, and this is on built on auto layout. But what if you want to place any item as a hover on auto layout? And this is the biggest problem, because when I'm hovering any item over the auto layout, it's automatically stacking this part inside this. To avoid this problem, what you can do, you can simply hold and press space key. And now you can simply hover. It will not take part of as an auto layout. So this is really helpful, I think, and you must know. So the last tip is selecting vectors directly. So let's say I have this icon over here, and you can see I have two vectors over here, and I want to select this line, only this line. For this, what you can do, you can press the command key, and you can right click over here, and now you can directly access this layers, all the layers, and whatever you want to select, you can select. In my case, I want to select this vector. simple and that. And also you can use only command key and the left key, left click, select any vector. This is your choice, but these are the shortcuts which save a lot of time. So that's it, guys. So let me know what tip you like so much in this video. I'm pretty excited to hear from you, from your experience, how you tried. And if you want to keep continue this video, maybe you should check out this grid system video, which is going to help you a lot if you want to create the grid in Figma. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks a lot.